MSNBC's Mika and Joe fight back at Trump, call him a liar, and say president begged her to come to Mar-a-Lago, as she denies facelift but says she had chin tweaked and it looks awesome, ginning up the president who says they're fake news. MSNBC hosts Joe Scarborough and Mika Brzezinski hit back at President Donald Trump this morning, calling him a liar and questioning his mental health, after their former friend claimed the duo relentlessly pursued him at Palm Beach property while Mika was recovering from a facelift. "We are both certain that the man is not mentally equipped to continue watching our show, Morning Joe," they said in a Washington Post op-ed on Friday morning. According to their account in the Post, Trump invited them to Mar-a-Lago for dinner. When Brzezinski didn't show, he asked them back the next night on New Year's Eve. They went, but did not attend the party he was having that night, they maintained. Mr. Trump also claims that Mika was bleeding badly from a facelift. That is also a lie, the op-ed says. Putting aside Mr. Trump's never-ending obsession with women's blood, Mika and her face were perfectly intact, as pictures from that night reveal. While Brzezinski never had a facelift, they admit that she did have a little skin under her chin tweaked, but this was hardly a state secret. Having postponed a 4th of July holiday by a day, the pair, who revealed their engagement last month, stopped by their show to rebut Trump in person on Friday morning. Brzezinski says they met privately with Trump and his wife in a bedroom and were led out through the party. "Talk about facelifts, whoa, Palm Beach," she said. The 50-year-old television host proudly talked about her chin tuck and declared, "It looks awesome." They also claimed on the show, and in the Post, that senior Trump officials begged them to call the president and apologize for their coverage or have a nasty piece on them run in a tabloid that's owned and operated by the president's friend. Trump responded with outrage on Twitter more than an hour after they made the on-air claim. "Watched low-rated at Morning Joe for first time in long time. Fake news. He called me to stop a National Enquirer article. I said no. Bad show." Trump confirmed with the tweet that he spent his morning stewing ahead of a scheduled call with the Turkish president and a White House visit from South Korea's Moon Jae-in. Scarborough tweeted back at him, "Yet another lie. I have texts from your top aides and phone records. Also, those records show I haven't spoken with you in many months. Why do you keep lying about things that are so easily disproven? What is wrong with you?" he asked in a follow-up. The MSNBC host previously revealed, in the opening minutes of he and Brzezinski's on-camera appearance, that he has friends in the White House telling him they have grown increasingly concerned about the president's erratic behavior. "We're okay. The country's not," he said. A senior member of Congress called him recently, Scarborough, a former congressman said, and told him that Trump went on a rant about Morning Joe in front of 20 or so legislators he was pitching on Obamacare repeal. "I've never made a call like this," Scarborough say his caller told him. "He scared me, because he was vicious when he turned from you to Mika." Scarborough's friend told him that Trump launched a Megyn Kelly-style attack on Brzezinski and talked about blood coming out of her ears, out of her eyes. "I was scared for you guys. And I wanted you to know," the senior Republican lawmaker reportedly told Scarborough. The Morning Joe hosts assessed that Trump that has a fixation with women, and he insults Brzezinski, with whom he has a disturbing obsession, more ferociously than Scarborough. "He appears to have a fragile, impetuous childlike ego that we've seen over and over again, especially with women. It's like he can't take it," Brzezinski stated. She said she was aware that Trump would respond to her needling on Thursday over fake Time magazine covers that hang in his clubhouses, but she stands by her joke. "It is unbelievably alarming that this president is so easily played. He's so easily played by a cable news host. Now what is that saying to our allies? What is that saying to our enemies that this president is so easily played?" Kellyanne Conway, the president's counselor, served at the White House's sacrificial lamb, Appearing on SABC on Friday morning as Brzezinski and Scarborough went to battle with her boss on MSNBC. "I endorse the president's right to fight back when he is being mercilessly attacked," she told ABC News' George Stephanopoulos. Clarifying her remarks, Conway said, "I didn't say I endorsed his attacks, I never said that. Bottom line, I endorse his ability to connect on social media with Americans." President Trump tore into the MSNBC hosts in Thursday morning tweets for trash-talking him on their show, prompting a huge backlash, with his own party speaking out against him. "I heard poorly rated at morning underscore Joe speaks badly of me, don't watch anymore. Then how come low IQ crazy Mika, along with Psycho Joe, came to Mar-a-Lago 3 nights in a row around New Year's Eve, and insisted on joining me? She was bleeding badly from a facelift. I said no." The tweet appeared to be in reaction to the hosts calling him a proven liar, and came after a series of clashes between him and Scarborough and Brzezinski, to whom he had previously been close. But it was the second time in a week he was caught up in a sexism row after he complimented a blonde Irish television reporter on her smile and called her over to his Oval Office desk. The Twitter rant appeared to be prompted by the content of Thursday's Morning Joe. During the first few minutes of Thursday's show, Scarborough had called out Trump for being a fake populist, and pointed a finger at Senate Republicans saying their health care bill gave tax cuts to their donors at the expense of robbing the poor. Brzezinski chimed in and said the president, a proven liar, made House Republicans look like fools, by making them celebrate their bill's passage in a Rose Garden ceremony last month. She also made fun of the size of his hands, calling them teensy. With glee. Trump sent the tweets minutes before the end of the duo's MSNBC program on Thursday, cutting down on their ability to respond immediately on air. They responded with tweets that mocked his little hands and invoked the First Lady's campaign to end cyberbullying but held back on a formal response until the next morning. First, they published an op-ed in the Post that said their concerns about his unmoored behavior go far beyond the personal. "America's leaders and allies are asking themselves yet again whether this man is fit to be president. We have our doubts," it said. "The president's unhealthy obsession with Morning Joe does not serve the best interests of either his mental state or the country he runs." They also disclosed a blackmail plot that was designed to get them to apologize to the president for their unflattering coverage. Top White House staffers told them the National Enquirer, which is owned by Trump friend David Becker, was planning to run a hit piece on them unless they begged the president to have the story spiked. "We ignored their desperate pleas," they wrote. On Morning Joe, they went further into the plot, revealing that 3 administration officials told them over and over again to call the president. Finally, they said, "Screw it. Let them run it. We're not calling," Brzezinski said. Brzezinski and Scarborough joined the show for a half hour, beginning at 7 a.m. on Friday to speak candidly about their dispute with the president that turned ugly on Thursday when he launched his personal attack on them on his personal social media channel. Willie Geist, a co-anchor of the program, began the show at 6 a.m. with an explanation of what had happened and spent the next hour asking show regulars to weigh in. "So, here's the deal. Joe and Mika were supposed to be on vacation today, long scheduled. They actually had tickets to last night's game up at Fenway Park in Boston, but it was going to be too much a circus. They were bringing their kids there, they didn't want to put them through that," the aftermath of all the tweets, he said. "So they stayed home to lay low, and I called and asked them to come in this morning to address this, to talk about the tweets and the reaction to them. So they agreed to do so." He said his friends would stop by before they do go away for the holiday weekend. "I asked Mika to come in particularly because she does not need me or anyone else to defend her, trust me, as everyone at this table knows. I suspect we do have some new viewers this morning, so I'll just say what anyone who's watched even 5 minutes of this show over the last decade already knows: Mika's smart. She's strong, She makes people in power uncomfortable and she fears absolutely no one, Geist said. He tossed Donny Deutsch, who was wearing shades as part of a bit that made fun of Trump's claims about Brzezinski's facelift. The regular guest noted that he is not an employee of NBC, then let Trump have it. Mika is a friend of ours. She's a good woman. She's a great mom and he's a pig. He's a vulgar pig. Michelle Obama says when they go low we go high. When he goes low, I'm going low. You guys can take the high road, Deutsch said. Deutsch did not stop there. Continuing, he said the president is physically disgusting to look at. He's not mentally okay, he added. Enough is enough with this disgusting vulgar man and to talk about women that way and the irony is you physically look like you do, beyond the stupidity of it. You are a pig. You are a bully. And you are doing disgusting things to this country. Geist attempted to talk him down, pointing out that remarks like that further lower the discourse. I'm taking the low ground here, he acknowledged. He goes after a woman that way. He goes after a friend that way. He is a vulgar human being. He is vulgar to look at. He is disgusting the way he behaves himself as president. As he finished, Deutsch said, I'm sorry, I probably won't be on the show again. And yet he was back on the panel later, when Brzezinski and Scarborough arrived. Asked to comment on Trump then, Deutsch told Scarborough, he's mentally ill. He also made a direct appeal to Trump, and challenged him to a schoolyard fight. The program host told him to put his sunglasses back on and stop encouraging gutter politics. I want to take it out of the schoolyard, Scarborough said. After Trump's tweets Thursday, Brzezinski and Scarborough smacked him on the social media platform, with the former sharing a little hands picture in a throwback to Trump's campaign argument with Senator Marco Rubio that morphed into a debate about the size of their appendages. Scarborough let CNN's Jake Tapper do the talking for him. This reminds me, how is that FLOTUS's campaign against cyberbullying going? The CNN host said in a message that Scarborough retweeted. NBC's Peter Alexander reported 10 minutes later that he had asked the First Lady's office about the anti-cyberbullying effort and as Spock says Melania's continuing to be thoughtful about her platform. More announcements TK. Later Stephanie Grisham, the First Lady's spokeswoman, said, as the First Lady has stated publicly, when her husband gets attacked, he will punch back 10 times harder. And Deputy White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders forcefully backed up her boss, saying he was in the right for calling the host psycho and crazy. This is a president who fights fire with fire and certainly will not be allowed to be bullied by a liberal media and the liberal elites within the media or Hollywood or anywhere else, Huckabee Sanders said Thursday morning on Fox News Channel. She commented an on-camera briefing later it's kind of like we're living in the Twilight Zone. I think that the president is pushing back against people who attack him day after day after day. Where's the outrage on that? She said in a lengthy defense of her boss. You guys are constantly coming and asking if this okay? If he does it one time. This is day after day after day and it's not just the president. The only person that I see a war on is this president and everybody who works for him. Continuing she said, I think I've been pretty clear that when the president gets hit he's going to hit back harder, which is what he did today. I don't think you can expect someone to be personally attacked day after day, minute by minute and sit back. Look, the American people elected a fighter. They didn't elect somebody to sit back and do nothing. They knew what they were getting when they voted for Donald Trump and he won overwhelmingly. Mark Ahernblau, head of PR for the NBC networks, said in an unofficial statement on Twitter just after Trump's tweets, Never imagined a day when I would think to myself, it is beneath my dignity to respond to the President of the United States. An official statement from MSNBC said, It's a sad day for America when the president spends his time bullying, lying and spewing petty personal attacks instead of doing his job. Republican leaders turned on Trump, exasperated by the tweets. Defeated presidential rival Jeb Bush tweeted, inappropriate. Undignified. unpresidential. Paul Ryan said they were not appropriate and Senator Lindsey Graham urged Trump to stop demeaning his office. Both hosts received support from other arms of the broadcast media, with CNN issuing a statement saying they stood with MSNBC. CNN senior media correspondent, Brian Stelter, posted a picture of Brzezinski at Mar-a-Lago when the president claimed she was bleeding from her facelift. Thursday's Morning Joe had opened up with an audio recording of Senator John McCain being asked if a health care deal was possible by the end of the week. "Pigs could fly," the Republican senator said. To which Brzezinski opened the show snarking, "Oh, so you're saying there's a chance," channeling the movie Dumb and Dumber. She snickered that Senate Republicans were faced with an awful prospect - working with Democrats. "It's really something. They're going to have to work with Democrats, like what a horrible idea, they're going to have to work with Democrats," Scarborough inserted. Brzezinski suggested that Senate Republicans should find it easier than working with President Trump. "Who undermines them, slams them, says bad things about them. Just for fun. To bully them, throw them under the bus, make up new plans, have Rose Garden ceremonies, humiliate them. I mean, could it be worse?" she said. "Why don't you work with Democrats?" she insisted. Scarborough then added that Trump doesn't understand any of the policy. "No clue," Brzezinski said. Scarborough suggested that Trump simply wanted a health care bill that he could pass, and didn't care about any of the details. "It doesn't line up with anything he promised on the campaign trail and he just doesn't understand the basic concepts," the former GOP House member added. Scarborough used the word "mean" to describe the bill, a word that Trump reportedly assigned to the House's version of the Obamacare repeal. Brzezinski again brought up the celebration Trump hosted in the Rose Garden when a bill had passed only in the House was months to years away from receiving the president's signature. "There was a Rose Garden ceremony where the president made everybody look like fools," she said. "A proven liar, and they went to the White House to be made to look like fools. It's amazing." Her counterpart then pointed out that on healthcare there were real opportunities for conservatives, as both Medicaid and Obamacare needed to be fixed, and free market principles could be used. "That would take real leadership," Brzezinski said. However, the ex-congressman noted, his party was focused on giving tax cuts to its donors. "At a time when the rich are getting richer and the poor are getting poorer at a faster rate than ever before in our nation's history, this is the point where Republicans say, 'Hey, we've got a great idea, we're going to cut $1 trillion of benefits from the poorest Americans and we're going to give it to the wealthiest Americans,'" Scarborough said. Brzezinski piled on, "And this was the president who was going to change Washington. What a populist," Scarborough added. He then looked directly into the camera. "Way to stand up to Goldman Sachs, Mr. President, we're really proud of you, buddy," he said. "Why don't you get another Time magazine cover?" Brzezinski said, referring to the Washington Post story that said fake Trump Time covers were hung at several of the president's resorts. With the fake Time cover on screen, Brzezinski laughed, "He's covering his hands here because they're teensy." Scarborough and Brzezinski, who announced their engagement to one another early last month, have had an on-again, off-again relationship with Trump. Early in the Republican primary they proclaimed that Trump was a legitimate candidate for the presidency, not some sideshow political act as some pundits tried to make the billionaire businessman out to be. But by February 2016, things started to sour, after Trump refused to disavow an endorsement made by the KKK's former leader David Duke. Scarborough called Trump's tepid response to Duke disqualifying. From then on, when Scarborough and Brzezinski criticized the candidate, he would take them to task with a tweet. However, by the time New Year's Eve at Mar-a-Lago rolled around, they seemed to be on firmer footing. So much so, that Vanity Fair reported that Trump offered later in January to marry the couple, and said they could use Mar-a-Lago, his private Florida resort, as the wedding venue. He also offered them the White House. Scarborough told the magazine that he and Brzezinski visited the White House in late January, just after Trump's inauguration, and the president told them over lunch with his daughter and son-in-law that they should hold their nuptials at his Palm Beach estate or his new home. That's when Jared interrupted and said, "Hey, you know what? I've got my license. I could marry you," Scarborough told Vanity Fair. The television host says that Trump jumped in and told Kushner, "Why would you marry them? They could have the President of the United States marry them." Brzezinski told Vanity Fair she's not interested. "The White House that I grew up in was an amazing place. If it weren't Trump, it might be something to think about," she said. "The mental picture is just fascinating, but the reality is just no, 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 no." They've been on bad terms again for some time now, and the Republican National Committee diagnosed them last month with Trump derangement syndrome. "This is funny stuff. Interesting to see Trump still obsessed with our show," Scarborough responded. "He should get a hobby or a new job that keeps him focused." Trump's tweet took them to task for their seemingly cozy relationship with him, that they say was in pursuit of an interview, as evidenced by their appearance at his Palm Beach resort for its annual New Year's Eve party. A CBS reporter, who was heading to the New York Times, shared a screen grab of a Times article describing the festivities at Trump's Mar-a-Lago Club on New Year's Eve, starting a Twitter battle with Scarborough on January 1. The article mentioned a red carpet and poolside cocktail party. Joe Scarborough and Michael Brzezinski from MSNBC's Morning Joe were also there, it said. So Pandeb, the CBS reporter, assessed in a tweet, "Morning Joe's hosts partied with Trump last night at Mar-a-Lago. Last year, Trump publicly thanked them for support." "Partied? You're very good at pushing fake news. You should write for CNN. Apparently making up facts is fine if you're writing about us," Scarborough replied. Rebutting him, Scarborough said, "Last year I said Trump's campaign was racist, xenophobic and disqualifying, but be snide while making facts up. Partied? Not even close." New York Times reporter Maggie Haberman, the author of the article that mentioned the Morning Joe host's presence at the Trump party, added fuel to the fire with a photo she shared on Twitter of Scarborough and Brzezinski talking to Trump at the soiree. The MSNBC personality and former Florida congressman said he and Brzezinski were on the property, and casually dressed, to ask for an interview with the president-elect. "Nothing that Mika and I did in setting up this meeting was any different than what all good reporters and news hosts try to do daily," Scarborough said. He continued to justify the Mar-a-Lago visit on Friday, first in the Washington Post, then on his television program. Scarborough also called on women in Trump's administration to take a stand against the president's bullying of women. "It's not just his fiancée," he argued, "it was NBC's Katie Turr, Alicia Machado, the beauty queen, Megyn Kelly. And by the way, we're not even saying about what he said privately. This congressman saying that he went into a rage talking about UN blood to 20 congressmen that he was actually whipping on the health care bill in the House. What does this say to young women and young girls, and what does it say about the women in the White House that won't step up and speak out?" Elaine Zhao, the transportation secretary, should say the president's behavior is not okay, he said. Zhao is a former labor secretary and the wife of Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell. Just this month, first daughter Ivanka Trump had marveled at the viciousness of Washington. "I think some of the distractions and some of the ferocity was, I was a little blindsided by on a personal level," she said in an appearance on Fox and Friends. "But, for me, I'm trying to keep my head down, not listen to the noise." Her father's tweeting has contributed to the noise, many Americans have said. Nearly 7 in 10 told pollsters for NPR and Marist that the president's use of the social media platform is reckless and distracting in a survey that dropped Wednesday. And yet, Huckabee Sanders, the deputy White House press secretary, insisted at an off-camera briefing on Wednesday that most people would say the opposite. I haven't seen the poll that you're referencing, but I do know that the president speaking directly to the American people is always a good thing. No matter who the president is, that's a positive no matter what, she told DailyMail.com. For the people to hear directly from their president, no matter what format that is in, whether it's through social media platforms, whether it's through speeches, whether it's through interviews, that's always a positive. And I think most people agree, she claimed. Brzezinski invoked a sexism row on Friday and Trump's leering and smiling at an Irish reporter who he finds attractive, and contended that his presidency has brought us back, like, 30 years. And I do think women in the White House need to know their value and step up and understand that they need to set him straight. So do the men. The sexism charges came after Trump's bizarre encounter with Catriona Perry, the Irish broadcaster RTE's Washington correspondent, earlier this week. She was one of a group of reporters in the Oval Office as Trump made a call to Leo Varadkar, Ireland's first openly gay prime minister, to congratulate him on his recent election win when he remarked, "Well, we have a lot of your Irish press watching us. They're just now leaving the room. And where are you from? Go ahead, come here. Where are you from? We have all of this beautiful Irish press. Where are you from?" beckoning to Imsbury. He then told the Irish leader that she had a beautiful smile on her face and added, "I bet she treats you well." As she stood awkwardly beside the desk, Imsbury continued smiling before gingerly making her way back to her seat. Others in the room giggled at the president's remark. Finally, the president delivered a message from the Irish prime minister. "He thanks you for the newspapers, Catriona," he said, prompting more laughs from the room. Perry shared a video of their encounter on Twitter afterwards, describing it as bizarre. Twitter users were quick to criticize the president's remarks. "Ms. Perry, please accept the apology of at least one female American," said one, while others deemed the president gross. "We apologize that our president is a weird, inappropriate creep," said another. "I'm sorry our president treated you this way," said another embarrassed U.S. citizen. Actor Kevin Chamberlain said, "He called you over to look you over. Gross," adding the hashtag embarrassed for my country. The outrage was of a similar tone to complaints about a 2005 recording of the president in which he boasted about grabbing women by the pee while he thought he was off camera. Huckabee Sanders argued at her on-camera briefing that everybody wants to make this an attack on a woman and not the constant attacks that Trump has been hit with. "I'm a woman and I've been attacked by this show multiple times. But I don't cry foul because of it. I think, you want to create this false narrative on one hand, let's treat everybody equally, and on the other hand they attack, 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 and he responds and that's wrong." In an especially pained moment, MSNBC's Holly Jackson asked Huckabee Sanders whether she'd tell her children that behavior like the president's is okay. The White House spokesman replied, "When it comes to role models, as a person of faith, I think we all have one perfect role model, and when I'm asked that question, I point to God, I point to my faith, and that's where I would tell my kids to look. None of us are perfect. And certainly there's only one that is, and that's where I would point them to."